كلمتان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن، خفيفتان على اللسان، ثقيلتان في الميزان.
دنیا کے سامنے اپنی جھوٹی عزت کے خاطر اس نے حضرت یوسف علیہ السلام کو جیل بھیج دیا، اور یہاں سرکار دو عالم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صبر کا پہاڑ بنے ہوئے ہیں. ام المؤمنین حضرت عائشہ صدیقہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ کا کئی ہفتوں اتنی بڑی تہمت پر اس طرح صبر کرنا، زندہ رہنا، یہ خود ان کی کرامت تھی. تو یہ بہت بڑا سبق انسانیت کے لیے کہ مٹھی بھر شر پسندوں کا ایک قبر کے اشارے سے صفایا ہو سکتا تھا، مگر آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے صبر کی تلقین فرمائی، امت کو درس دیا کہ ایسے حالات واقعات پیش آئیں تو صبر و تحمل سے کام لینا چاہیے.
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. الحمد للہ الذی ابدأ الافلاک والارضین والصلاة والسلام علی من کان نبیا وآدم بين الماء والطين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عدد ما في علم الله، صلاة دائمة بدوام ملك الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربنا يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح. اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك. أما بعد، حضرين كرام، our honorable Hazrat says that for the past week the topic under discussion was Surah An-Nur, which started since Monday. And Hazrat was saying that it was connected to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family, his young, beautiful, beloved, innocent wife, mother of the believers, Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha. That the munafiqeen of Medina, hypocrites of Medina, the enemies of Allah and his Rasul, started speaking ill of the Prophet's family, accusing her, Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, ma'adallah, of zina and adultery. On the other hand, and this Hazrat says that Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the pain that she suffered, the gham, the grief, the huzn, the worry, the sadness, the difficulty, and it did not stay for one day or for 2 days, but for weeks. Hazrat says that the fact that Hazrat Aisha remained alive to be blamed of something like that, Medina, the talk in Medina, the wife of the Prophet, to be blamed for her to be remaining alive for that time itself is a miracle. On the other hand, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kept sabr, patience and tolerance. His example was like that of Yusuf ala nabiyina alayhi salatu wassalam, Prophet Yusuf, Joseph. Here Prophet Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam is being seduced by Zulaikha, the wife of the minister of Egypt. Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam is running away from her, getting away from her, does not want to fall into this sin. Zulaika is seeing the miracles of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before her eyes. That the seven doors she had closed as Yusuf ala nabina wa alayhi salatu wa salam was running, the seven doors started opening one by one automatically. She witnessed that. The Aziz of Misr, when he entered, she also witnessed another miracle. That the Quran says, وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا, that a witness from the people of that house, from her family, bore witness, testified. A child in the cradle, young child drinking milk, spoke and gave it testimony to the truthfulness of Hazrat Yusuf ala nabiyina wa alayhi salatu wa salam. But position and power is something else. The minister of Egypt, the Aziz of Egypt, the noble of Egypt, despite the fact that he had the knowledge of the innocence and the barati of Yusuf alayhi salam, decided to send Yusuf to prison because his name, his house, there will be blame upon the name of his family and his household. To save that, he sent him to prison. Yusuf alayhi salam kept sabr and patience. Here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is undergoing difficulty. Outwardly, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could have destroyed the munafiqeen. They were no match for him. They were no match for him, for his force outwardly. Inwardly, with respect to his ruhani taqat, his spiritual strength, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed the Prophet so much. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had loved the Prophet so much that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had only to think in his heart of some form of revenge and vengeance against these people, only to think it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bring it to pass. But no, on the contrary, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bore patience, he had sabr, tahammul, he bore this with forbearance, with strength, with fortitude. Why? As a sabak for the ummah, as a lesson for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when big calamities come, big distress comes in, remember the example, says Allah, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ, that in the Rasul, messenger of Allah, in him is a very fair example, the best example for you, that when difficulties come our way, great hardships and great difficulties, to reflect upon this sabr and patience that the Rasul alayhi salam kept.
شروع میں میں نے عرض کیا تھا کہ کسی واقع عشق کا کوئی انصاف کی نظر سے مطالعہ کرے اور سرکار دو عالم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے جس طرح اتنے ہفتے صبر و تحمل کے ساتھ گزارے, صرف وہ وقت نہیں بلکہ اس کے بعد کا وقت, تو اس کی آنکھیں کھولنے کے لیے یہی واقعہ کافی ہے کہ کس قدر رواداری کا مذہب, صبر اور تحمل کا مذہب, کس قدر آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی رحمت للعالمین ذات. اور آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم ان سب کو برداشت فرما رہے ہیں, اور اس کے بعد بھی جب تخت اعلی شانہ کی طرف سے برات نازل ہوتی ہے اور پوری سورہ نور جس میں برات بھی صاف صاف, ہماری امی جان ام المؤمنین حضرت عائشہ صدیقہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ فرماتی ہے کہ میں اپنے آپ کو اس سے بہت فقیر اور کمتر سمجھتی تھی کہ میرے بارے میں قرآن میں کوئی آیت اتری